Climate resilience is the biggest challenge for us all. We aim to identify a balance between the needs of a growing world population and the finite capacity and health of our planet. We've got extreme weather events, ecological disruptions, extreme temperatures, fires. We've got a huge amount of existing infrastructure that we've got to retrofit and try and make work. We've got a lack of industry standards for collecting data. Using the best technology that's available has to be part of that solution as we move forward. Arup's primary goal is to develop a truly sustainable built environment. The way we set up our projects, we bring BIM and GIS experts together right from the start. We can turn BIM from just being a group of spaces into a place by putting it in context. By being able to make contextual information more available earlier, it means that everybody can get some level of perspective about what it means to be there and what the design solutions could be for that space. From the start, it means that we can be a little bit more informed about our site selection. Being able to use GIS data to understand where flood zones are, where runoff is going to have most of its impact. We're going to have to do less risk mitigation. Problems that are going to come due to climate impacts in the future. And it also means that they can maybe score some more points for their LEED accreditation. I find it really rewarding when we get groups of different stakeholders together who aren't GIS or BIM natives, but are able to focus on the real problems at hand because the solutions are so intuitive and accessible to them. BIM and GIS are just information. And if we can break down the silos and make them more accessible to different people and a more diverse range of people, then we're going to see more innovative solutions. That's really exciting. And I can't wait to see what comes next.